Hi everybody, my name is Jacob, and I'm 15 years old. You have probably realized already that I have a younger sister. Her name is Ariana, and our parents love her more than they love me. I've noticed that the youngest siblings are always the parents' favorites. You probably have as well, but what can one do about it? Well, I have an answer to that question. Subscribe to the channel, and I will tell you the story of how I fought for the attention of my parents, and what came out of it. When I was little, I had all of my parents' attention. I was the only child in the family, after all. I was pampered, they never punished me, and indulged all of my whims. What a life I was living. But then, Ariana was born, and everything immediately turned upside down. It was as if they'd forgotten about me at once. They started paying attention only to her. My sister became the most important person in the family. Mom and Dad waited on her hand and foot. I thought our parents would calm down when she grew up a bit and love us equally, but as time passed, Ariana was still their favorite. She turned 11 and she was still Mom and Dad's baby princess. While I only ever heard from them, "Jay, take out the trash." It was quite harmful, to be honest. I was angry at the injustice of it all. My mother brought my sister new clothes almost every month. I, however, had been wearing the same jeans for 3 years. They gave her the coolest smartphone for her birthday. I only got a book and a cake, half of which was eaten by my sister. My mother made me eat vegetables because they were good for me. Ariana got pizza and tacos if she even hinted at wanting them. Basically, it was clear in everything they did that our parents loved my sister more than me, and it hurt a lot. You might be wondering why I didn't talk to them about this. Well, I tried to explain what I was feeling once, but my dad only said, "Jay, why are you competing with Ariana? She's younger, just leave her be." Obviously, I did not like that answer, especially since that sly little girl had realized that she could do anything she wanted and became completely unbearable. One day, she went to take some candy Mom and Dad had hidden from us in a cupboard and dropped my mother's favorite teapot. Of course, it broke into pieces. When I saw that, I thought that Ariana was going to get in trouble for sure. Our parents came running into the kitchen and asked what was wrong. And then she told them,
"Jacob tried to take a candy and broke your teapot, Mummy."
What? I began to tell them that it hadn't been me who had done it, but her. But they didn't even listen to me and believed Ariana. I was punished and left without any sweets for a whole month. I saw her smile meanly as she stole glances at me. I'd run out of patience and declared war on my sister. I needed our parents to get angry with her. I thought for a long time about ways to achieve that, and a whole plan was born in my head. First of all, I sneakily put her brand new expensive smartphone on the very edge of the table while we were having lunch. Naturally, Ariana didn't notice and pushed it with her elbow. The smartphone fell onto the floor and broke. I thought she would be scolded for being absent-minded and irresponsible, but Dad just smiled and said he would buy her a new one. Damn it! It hadn't worked! So I moved on to my next mean plan. On my way back from school, I picked up the dirtiest, most flea-ridden puppy I could find on the street. Then I left it outside our house, knocked on the door, and hid around the corner. Ariana came out, saw the puppy, and dragged it to her room, of course. In the evening, when our parents came home, the puppy's dirty footprints were all over the house floor, and my sister was itching all over. She was definitely going to get in trouble because our mother didn't like pets. But Mom just smiled and said, "What a beautiful dog. Let's wash and groom it. Jay, wipe all these footprints off the floor." What? How was that fair? I couldn't believe my ears. Did my mother love Ariana so much that she would let her get away with absolutely anything? And then I realized that I needed to get more serious if I wanted to succeed. I began to sneak into my sister's room at night. I took her homework out of her school bag and messed it up by writing all the wrong answers. There was no way she would get away with that. Very soon, Ariana began to bring only bad grades home from school. Our parents couldn't help but notice. Do you think they punished her? If only. My dad just called me over and said, "Jay, your sister is not doing well at school. You will tutor her and help her do her homework." How was that even happening to me? Now I did all of Ariana's homework for her while she played with her puppy without a care in the world. I felt so awful. I'd lost the war to her,
And then I decided to make one last desperate attempt. I decided to run away from home. Maybe if I disappeared, Mom and Dad would realize how bad they would feel without me and start to value me. So one evening, I put some food, warm clothes, and the book they had given me for my birthday into my backpack. I wrote a farewell note, left it on the table in my room, and left. I didn't know where I was going or how long I would be on the run. I hadn't thought my plan through, really. I just walked down the street and thought at that very moment, my mom was probably coming into my room and noticing that I wasn't there. Then she would find the note. I imagined her getting scared and calling for Dad. Together, they would start calling all of my friends, trying to figure out where I might have gone. An awful Ariana would understand that it had all happened because of her. Such thoughts made me feel warm and happy. I looked around and realized that I had gone quite far from home. So far that I didn't even know where I was. I had been so deep in my thoughts that I hadn't noticed how I'd got lost. No, I needed to stay calm. I simply needed to turn back around and walk until I reached a familiar street. I put on my headphones, turned on the music on my smartphone so it wouldn't be so boring while I walked. Meanwhile, night had fallen, and it had gotten quite dark. The further I went, the surer I became that I was going in the wrong direction. I found myself in some dark part of the city. There were rundown buildings and fences all around me. I had no idea where I was or which way my house lay. To be honest, I was scared. I could just make out some frightening silhouettes in the darkness, staring at me. Who were they and what did they need? At that moment, for the first time, I wished I hadn't run away from home. I imagined that right at that moment, my parents and the police were searching the area for me. Mom was probably crying and Dad was scolding Ariana and saying it was all her fault. I decided that I taught my family enough of a lesson and it was time for me to go home. But in which direction was I supposed to go? I had no idea where home was. Public transport was no longer running. I was too afraid to ask anyone for directions. Who knew what sort of people were roaming the streets in the dark of the night? A couple hours after that, I realized that I was terribly tired. I decided to get over my pride and call my parents. But when I took out my phone, I saw that the battery had died. I had been listening to music for so long that it had run out. That's when I truly got scared. I realized that running away from home had been a really bad idea, and that finding yourself in a hopeless situation was terrible. I spent the whole night walking around the city in search of my home. It was only in the morning that I accidentally saw a familiar building. I quickly found my way from it and was soon standing in front of the door of our house. I was so tired, completely wiped out. Still, I was proud of myself for having taught my parents a lesson. They'd probably also stayed up all night looking for their son, and now they would hug me, relieved. But as soon as I got home, I was immediately struck by the silence. The living room was empty. Where was everyone? I went quietly into our parents' bedroom to find my mom and dad and saw them calmly snoring. My sister Ariana was also sleeping, as if nothing had happened. I hadn't been expecting that. I found the note I had written in my room, untouched. That's when my mother came into my room, looking sleepy. She saw me all dressed, carrying a backpack, and calmly said, "Oh, Jacob, are you ready for school already? Don't slam the door when you leave. We'll sleep some more." It was a fiasco. They hadn't even noticed my disappearance. Who had I run away from home for? I realized that I couldn't change anything. Mom and Dad would still love my little sister more, no matter what I did. I decided to accept it and just move on. But fate is real, and just a few days later, it brought me quite a surprise. One night, our parents were especially solemn at dinner, and my father said, "Jacob, Ariana, your mother and I have some news for you. Soon, you will have a brother or a sister." Wow, my mother was pregnant. Ariana screamed with joy and hugged her, and I looked at my sister and smiled maliciously. She didn't know what she was in for yet. Very soon, she would no longer be the youngest. Have you guessed what happened next? When our little sister Mia was born, my parents completely switched to caring for her.
Ariana immediately stopped getting the attention and love she had been so used to. Dad made her take out the trash and do the cleaning. And my mother told her to eat vegetables because they were good for her. Finally, my sister felt what it was like to be me, how difficult it was for her. However, I no longer felt happy that she had got what she deserved, but genuinely sorry for her. One day, she came to my room in tears and told me that Mom and Dad didn't love her anymore. I hugged Ariana and said it wasn't true. They loved us all the same. The elder children simply became more mature and responsible in their eyes. Someone who could be independent. That's why they gave all of their attention to the younger ones. Maybe I really should grow up a bit. What do you think? Write in the comments down below. After all, your family's story might be quite similar to mine.